So excited. Look what came in the mail today. My NABU. So I have it hooked up backwards just so that my cable is not long enough to reach to the computer. So this is the 5-pin DIN connector for the network adapter. It's an RS422 at 111,000 kilobits. Connected to a USB converter, plugged into my laptop. And I got a little program here analyzing the communication back and forth. So let me show you what happens. So right now I'm at a stage where it's trying to load the menu and trying to do something. So let's, here's my little program I created. So what I'll do is I'm just going to reach around the front here and hit the reset button. And then I'm going to push connect on here. So it'll boot up. And then it's going to beep a couple times. It's going to ask for some data. So there we go. So the computer talked back and forth to the, the real computer talked back and forth to the NABU computer, and it authenticated itself, said, I am a network adapter, blah, blah, blah. And now it's prompted in the ROM. There's some code in here that says, enter the channel code. And I guess this is some sort of code you get for different programs because they just have, programs on the cable just being sent, transmitted, like a carousel, and you just receive it. So I found out that just typing in 0000050s will work, because if I just type in any other hex values here, like if I put some other hex values in here, it'll say retype in a channel code. So there's a little bit of logic in there, which is interesting. So I'll type in zeros, and then I'll go back to my program. You can see my zeros were sent. I fired off a bunch of other data. Now it thinks it's loading right now. So technically I could just start feeding it data and it's gonna load it into memory address 010000. And it'll execute it, I guess, when it's done. I need some data, some software to be able to load into this thing. That's the next step, is to see if I can locate software somewhere on the internet. Otherwise, I can probably figure out a way to compile something. I do have quite a bit of information here that I've been able to scrounge up. For example, the technical spec doc here is pretty useful. It talks about all the different control registers and everything, which is nice. So you get an idea of where the sound generator is. I know what chip it is, so I should technically be able to send data to the sound generator, should be able to send some data to the video display processor. Otherwise, I got this document. Yeah, this is a pretty big document here. This has everything, because the iOS and the DOS have a bunch of interfaces already for programming. It's their, essentially it's their BIOS. So there's a bunch of DOS calls you have. So for example, if you want to load directories, accessing directories, and there's headers. There's a header on every single, everything you get from disk, well, disk or cable, right? So here's the discussions of the headers and the different addresses where the data will be loaded in. And if we keep going down further, you get into all of their multi-window screen driver code, everything in here. So if we can find the list files and the header files for all of this, I mean, we could start writing some code. There's some talk about the MSX and the NABU being similar hardware-wise, yes, but the trouble here is the ports are considerably different. And also you'll find too is that what I read here is that the MSX software is encouraged to use the BIOS ROM, which means it's gonna be communicating using predefined functions already in ROM. So unless you find a program that's talking directly to the hardware, but then you still have to be able to convert the hardware over to from different addresses. So anyway, so back to the NABU after my ramble here. You can see here we got a message from Rom saying, if something goes wrong, see the owner's guide, which is pretty cool. Cool in the sense that it's doing something. So now we just need to get some software on this thing.